So, we are revising how to make a diagonal scale. For the scale, you will get a simple statement, which can be like this: 1 inch equals to 14 feet. First thing it will be to convert this scale in a easily multipliable number. So that is also called as the rounding off process. After rounding off, and how the rounding off is done, we consider the ground unit, it is 14, and we will select a number which is nearest to 14, which is easily multipliable. So the number which is nearest to 14 is 10, so we have divided 14 by itself and multiplied with the desired number. So we got this statement. This is a statement which is for labeling, like it's 0.76 inches equals to 10 feet. So this will be for our labeling. And on every primary division, we will label at a distance of 10 feet. So here you can see on that scale, it's 0, 10, 20, 30, 40. 50, 60, 70. So this is for labeling. And then now for construction, we will consider the biggest value which we have measured in the field. And here I have given an example that the biggest value which we have measured is 76 feet. So we have to make a scale up to 80, because 80 is a multiple of 10. So how we will do that, we will make 10 into 80, and how 10 can be made 80 by multiplying with 8. So we will multiply this labeling scale by 8 to construct a scale. So we will multiply by 8. (0.76 × 8) = (10×8). Then we will have something around 6 feet. So after making this statement, 5.7 inch equals 10×8, we will draw a line which will be equals to 5.7 inches. And after drawing that line, we will bisect. We will either bisect the line, or we will use the angle method to divide the line into 8 equal parts. So to divide it into 8 equal parts, the easiest method, which I feel is easiest, is to draw angles. Like draw one angle over here and one angle over here. Make 7 arcs along this line, make 7 arcs along this outer line, and connect each arc with the arc, corresponding arc on the opposite line. So that's how you will get the primary divisions. And how many division types are there in a diagonal scale? We have primary, we have secondary, we have tertiary. So the red ones are primary divisions. Then the ones with blue over here, these are secondary divisions, SD. Then we have the tertiary divisions. primary, secondary, and tertiary divisions. Now we have made the primary division, we have made the secondary division. Now it's time to make the tertiary divisions. To make tertiary divisions, we have to find out the value of the secondary division. So here the value of primary division to make TD, tertiary divisions, consider the value of SD. And here the value of SD is 1 foot. We have to measure smallest distance of 1 inch on the ground. So in 1 foot, how many inches are there? There are 12 inch, 1 foot equals 12 inches. So we have to make 12 tertiary divisions. To make the tertiary divisions, we have to make horizontal lines. We will make horizontal lines parallel to the original green scale. The line in green, that is the original scale. So we will make 12 parallel lines because the number of tertiary divisions will be 12. So these number of horizontal lines will be equal to the number of tertiary divisions. You will make 12 lines. Now, to make these 12 lines, the best way is to first make a perpendicular at the start of line and make another perpendicular at the end of line. You can use set square for this step. Set square will be easiest to make this perpendicular line, perpendicular making an angle of 90 degrees. Okay, now what will be the distance between these lines, the first line and the second line? So it's up to you. It depends upon the space you have on the paper. If we consider the paper which we use in our survey, then we see that we can ideally take the distance of 0.5 centimeter between these lines here, or we can take the distance of 0.3 centimeters. And if you are taking the inch scale, then you can take a distance of 0.2 inches. Let me write these down. Distance between TD lines, tertiary division lines, can be ideally 0.4 centimeter or 0.2 inches. So it's up to you, whichever system you are using, you will mark the lines. After marking, after making these horizontal lines, make perpendicular to each primary division. Again, set square can be used for this. Perpendicular line for each primary division. After making all these perpendiculars, what you have to do is to mark the secondary divisions on the topmost line. Mark secondary divisions on the topmost line. Here again, to mark these divisions up there, you may use the set square. That is the best option. You will mark the tertiary division on the topmost line by using set square, keeping the set square at this point, and then marking on the topmost line. After marking it in the left-hand most division, only we will mark the tertiary divisions only in this section from 0 to 10 on the left-hand side. Then we will connect the 0 we will connect the 0 with the next value. Just remember, whenever we are making diagonals in the diagonal scale, the diagonal scale is called as a diagonal scale because we draw the diagonals in the to make the tertiary divisions. So to make the diagonals, always make sure we start from 0 and we connect the 0 with the next bigger number. So from 0, the next bigger number is this one, which is 1 inch. So we will connect this with the second one. And now we will connect the second division with the third one on the topmost line. And we will have the diagonals. This is a diagonal scale. And after making all the lines, you have to label the tertiary divisions. If you want to ask anything, beta, type down. Because I think you guys are using data, and in data, voice is not clear. Okay, so this is a diagonal scale. After doing that, you have to label these floors. I call these as floors, these horizontal lines as floors. Okay, there's a request that I should take journals on theory exams day. Okay, just submit that on your theory exam. Okay, so this is the diagonal scale and how the value will be measured. Let's see. First, let's complete the labeling. So we have 10 lines here. We cannot label all of these. So let's label the middle one. It will be 5 inches in the middle. And then now we understand this is 1 inch, 2 inch, 3 inch. Similarly, label the topmost line here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 inches here. And we can easily label these, all these flows. One inch, 2 inches, and similarly you have to label the things up till here, which the highest one will be 12 inch or 1 foot. Okay, so there's a question that from where I got this 0.7 and 5.7 here. So when we divide this 1 divided by 14 multiplied by 10, when I solve this, I will get 0.7. And here is but mistakenly I have written 0.76. It's 0.71. Okay. So when we multiply 0.71 with 8, we will have 5.7 inches. And the length of this scale, the green line, it is 5.7 inches long.
मैम हमने 8 से मल्टीप्लाई क्यों किया?
We have multiplied this with 8 because हमें 76 feet तक measure करना था. क्यों करना था 76 feet तक? क्योंकि 76 feet was the longest measured value from field book. हमने जब सर्वे कंडक्ट किया तो we have seen that कि जो हमें मैक्सिमम लाइन मेजर करनी है उसकी लेंथ 76 feet थी. तो 76 feet के